Welcome back to the channel. It's Emily, and today I'm going to be doing my top rides at Walt Disney World. So, as you know, I've been filming a lot of videos lately about Disney with my brother, but today I'm just going to be alone, and I'm going to give you my top five favorite rides at all Walt Disney World. So, but wait, before we go into the video, make sure to press that like button and subscribe to my channel, turn it from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now, let's get on to the video. Starting with number five, it is Test Track at Epcot. This is one of my favorite rides because of the speed and like the theme of the ride's really fun. It's all about testing out your car that you make while you're in line. You really make a car, like design a car while you're in line to go on the ride, and then you get to test it on the runway and see how you do and see if you get in first place. And it's really fun. I really like it. That's why it's number five. My number four ride is Animal Kingdom's Expedition Everest. And I like this ride again because of the theme where you're trying to find the mythological character, the Yeti, and you're on Mount Everest, and you go through and you're trying to find the Yeti, and then a big drop comes at the end. And I really like it. It's more on the thrill side, so it's one of the rides that I really enjoy. And yeah, that's why it's number four. My number three ride is the Mine Train at Magic Kingdom. I like this ride because it's super fun. I love the movie Snow White and Seven Dwarfs, and so I love the ride. It's one of my favorites. It's not really on the thrill side for me. Maybe for you, but not that thrill for me. It is a little bit more thrilling than others, but yeah. So that's why it's number three. My number two ride is Space Mountain at Magic Kingdom Tomorrowland because I love this ride. I love it. It's one of my all-time favorite rides. I love the speed. Not real fast, but it's really fun. You got tight turns. It's like you're on a mission to space, basically. And you're going through like all of space. It's really fun. And yeah, it's one of my all-time favorite rides. I love it. It's just really, really one of my favorites. That's why it's number two. And my all-time number one favorite ride ever in Walt Disney World is Rock and Roller Coaster at Hollywood Studios. This is one of my all-time favorite rides, my number one favorite ride, because of the speed, the takeoff, the corkscrews, the loops, the theming, just everything about it I love. It's one of my favorite rides. It's definitely a thrill ride. If you're into thrilling rides, definitely make sure to ride this if you have not already. It's fun. It usually has kind of like, it's not really long, but it's never really short. Definitely either get fast pass for it or get to the park early so you can get on that ride as soon as you get there. But it's definitely worth it. I love it, and you will love it too if you love thrill rides like that. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to press that like button, subscribe to my channel, turn it from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Also, comment down below what your favorite ride at Walt Disney World is. Mine's Rock and Roller Coaster, so what's yours? Also, make sure to subscribe to my brother's channel. I'll put his links down there, and I'll put some of my previous videos and some of his previous videos down there too. So, yeah, that's it for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Hey guys, it's Emily, and today I'm here with...
Jeremy Thompson. You might see other videos in the link in the description.
Yeah, if there's any there. And today we're going to be doing our top rides at Magic Kingdom and Epcot. We did two separate videos on his channel for our favorite rides at Hollywood Studios and Animal Kingdom. Make sure you check those out if you haven't already. And make sure to subscribe to his channel. He does okay videos. And comment down below that I sent you, and make sure to like his videos. Now let's get on to our favorite rides at Magic Kingdom. All right, so first.
first, we're gonna start with Magic Kingdom. Why don't you do your favorite?
All right, my top ride in Magic Kingdom is Mine Train. More than likely, I said this big fast pass for this ride. It's about 67 minutes away from all the time. Let's get the ride to park open, and maybe lucky 30 minutes. Pretty much when you go the ride, you go through a couple interactive things, and then once you get on the ride, you're in the mine car that sways back and forth. Something you should check out.
Alright, my first favorite ride at Magic Kingdom is Space Mountain. I like this ride because it is more on the thrill side. It has tight turns. You never know which way you're going to go unless you've ridden it a couple times and you know where you're going. And you're in like tiny little spacecraft. It's a more future world space themed ride. And usually the time is different in different days. Like it depends on the day. Sometimes it's 60, sometimes it's 20. So you might just be lucky you get on it right then, or you might have to wait in line. But it's definitely a fun ride to check out and check out to ride
it. My next one is Splash Mountain, which goes by how I see it. You get wet and describes a lot for a ride that you go through pretty much a story based on the song itself. You have Briar Bear, Briar Fox, all those characters. Briar Patch.
Yeah. It's splashed.
Yeah, but it's definitely something you should check out.
Alright, my second and last one for Magic Kingdom, one of my favorites, is the People Mover. And I know you're thinking, okay, I've been on the People Mover and it's like not even fun at all. But when you get older and you are tired all the time from walking and standing in line from rides, you just gotta take a little break. And this ride is never has a wait time. And it's actually pretty long. Not really long, but it's about 4 to 5 minutes maybe at a time. And you just ride through like different things. You go around the park and you see some of the things. And if you ride at night, you might even see the fireworks show. So, and yeah, it's definitely a ride to like just take a break and cool down.
My next one is Thunder Mountain. So pretty much, yeah, almost all the mountains. Thunder Mountain's pretty much you're in a runway mine train. It's one of the longest rides at Walt Disney World. Yeah, at least there's three lift hills that you go on, but it's at least a 4 minute ride, 5 minute ride.
Starting with Epcot, my first favorite is Test Track. This is definitely a ride that you might need to get fast passes for, or if you get there early, go straight to that ride, because usually this is a pretty long ride. So what you do is while in line, you get to design your own car, how fast it goes, brakes, the designing, like just how it looks, and it's super fun. And then when you get on your ride, you see how your car does. And so it's super fun. Have speed, tight turns, you almost get hit by a truck. If you want to see that, check out YouTube videos, or you can check it out yourself. And then, yeah, so it's a super fun ride that you might need fast passes for, but it's definitely worth the wait. What's yours?
That's Soaring, which is a flight simulation ride that you sit in and you feel like you're hang gliding over. I've seen people that have scare of heights ride it and they love it. It doesn't really scare them that bad.
And like there's a top, a middle, and a bottom, so you can probably get on the bottom if that. Like, it feels the same no matter where you are. All right, the last ride for this video in Epcot is Mission Space. So there's two lines that you can get in. First line is Mission Space Green, which is a little bit more like
less
calm
intense.
Ride. It's not intense at all. And you're going on like kind of a little like mission around Earth. And it's super fun, super laid back. It's also another one of those rides that you can basically sleep on. I mean, you don't have to do controls. They'll do it for you. But it's a super fun ride that I would suggest. And then on Mission Space Orange, on the other hand, this is more of an intense ride. You get like a lot of pressure, a lot of force on you. It's like you're really going into space. And then it's a mission to Mars. So this is two rides in one that I would definitely suggest. Usually the green is a lot less, but sometimes it's more because a lot of little kids go to Disney World, but you could get Fast Pass for it if you want to. I would not, but it's a ride that I think is pretty good, so go check it out. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to press that like button and comment down below what your favorite ride at Epcot or at Magic Kingdom is. And make sure to go subscribe to my channel. Click the bell to get notified when I post a video. And I guess you can click the link in my description box below if you want to. If it's down there, I might not put it down there.
YouTube.com/channel.
Or you can just stay at my channel and watch all my videos with my opinion. Or tonight. Bye. y'all won't get that far. So again, thank you guys for watching and I'll see you guys next time.
Welcome back to the channel, and today I am here with my brother Jeremy. You've seen him before. I'll make sure to put his links down below. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to him. Also, click the bell to get notified when he posts a video and when I post a video. He posts every Tuesday and Thursday, and I post about every week. So today, we are unboxing our Disney Magic Bands for Disney World because we're going in January. So yeah, we're just going to do that. We're also going to go through the evolution of the like tickets to get into Disney World. So yeah, without further ado, let's get on to the video.
Alright guys, let's get this unboxing started.
Let's do it.
Get my open box up and let's see what's inside. Now, we have unboxed this box before, because if you do notice that, we got it in the mail. We didn't know what it was, but we did open it up to see what's inside. And like, oh, there's Magic Bands. Let's do a video. So, like, okay, let's see what's inside.
Right. Even though I've already seen it. So, here's Magic Bands.
Magic Bands.
So, my mom has yellow, I have purple, my brother has green, and my dad has blue.
All right, let's see what comes inside the box.
All right, so of course we have Magic Bands. Over on this side, we have our Magic Band information. And this is all that's in there is just this little paper. And it says basically what the thing is. Jeremy, can you read some bullet points over there?
Yeah. This Magic Band helps you get inside the parks. It accesses your Fast Passes, which you can do on My Disney Experience. You can get that in the App Store or on the Google Play list. You can also connect it to your photo pass. So this is the photo service that Disney provides for you, where everybody in the family can be in the picture.
Yeah.
And you just take the picture wherever they are in most parts of the parks.
And you can also take pictures with Disney characters. One of my favorite places to take pictures with Disney characters is at Epcot. I'm not really sure what the place is called, but it has like a whole line through where you can take pictures with characters.
That's right. Alright, and then also this works as your room key, so the kids, they don't have to like, Mom, come, can I open the door when you got to get the key out of the wallet and everything. No, all they do is throw their Magic Band up there, and they're in the room. So yeah, and also this works as a credit card. You can just like make it as one if you just said use Dad's as the credit card, and he can hit the Magic Band Mickey to Mickey's when you're eating somewhere or purchasing something in the parks. It works as a credit card. Alrighty, let's see what's on the other side.
So on the other side is our luggage tags, which match our Disney Magic Band colors. For my mom, we have Mickey Mouse, which is yellow. For mine, purple, we have Mickey and Minnie. For Jeremy's, we have green, which is Goofy. And for blue, for my dad, is Donald Duck. And so on the little card it comes with, it just says, luggage tag straps are located inside your gray Magic Band holder. It's in the Magic Band.
That'll be inside the thing that's holding our Magic Bands. So yeah, we're not going to be needing these. We are traveling by car.
But I might use it on my backpack that I'm going to be carrying to Disney World that I will be filming soon after Christmas. I'll be filming what's in my backpack.
And don't forget, I will be doing what is in mine also, and what kind of equipment I carry to film and all that. So be looking up for that in around January.
Yeah.
Or maybe the end of December, call when the upload schedule happens. But yeah, don't forget to look at that. Alright, let's take the Magic Bands out of here. Alright, so it's easy to take out, as you can tell right there. And there you have the four Magic Bands for each of us in the family. Alright, let's throw this box aside.
And hit the light.
Yeah. Alright, so here's our four Magic Bands. You have my dad's, myself, Emily's, and my mom's.
My mom's.
Alright, so here's our four Magic Bands. We have our dad's, mine, Emily's, and Emily.
Apparently my mom doesn't matter anymore. Let me do this.
Here's our four Magic Bands. Here's my dad's, mine, Emily's, and our mother's. So yeah, we were talking about the luggage tags for things to connect them to your luggage. So you open up the side here, and they should be in here, if they are. The four clear covers to throw over those to put in your on your luggage. You have to, so you put it through, then you see a little slit right there. You put it in, and then you turn.
And
then you got it in your luggage. Or on your backpack or whatever.
And also on the back, just in case you don't know if it's yours, somebody else is traveling with the same luggage tag and the same luggage, you can also put your name, your address, and your phone or email on there just in case somebody finds it and then you can get back to you.
So here's our four Magic Bands, just set them right here. Now we do have something pretty cool we thought of to do. We're going to show you the evolution of Magic Bands and Magic Tickets to get you in the park. So yeah, let's see what that is like.
Alright guys, so let's get on to the evolution of our Disney tickets.
Alright, so when the tickets first started, or not really first started, because you know the paper back then, but since we've been going back in 2000 on, this is the evolution since 2000 to now 2017. So here's the first card, it is the older ticket. This is actually from 2009. This is a darker colored ticket, looks like a credit card almost. It works the same thing as the Magic Bands. Except for the credit card usage, it got you in the rooms and into the park. Then we go to 2013. This is pretty much the same design, but the look of it is a little lighter, and it works just the same as the other
one.
And
the castle's on the opposite side.
So you put on that. And then the newer ones now have, or did have, not now, but did have, they started putting characters on them. So this one does have Dumbo on it. This was back in 2015.
All right, now getting on to the Magic Bands, which is today's tickets. So the first Magic Band ever created was the Magic Band 1.0, and it's just a skinny little Magic Band with a Mickey Mouse on it, and you could choose whatever color you want. And also we have a Magic Band 1.0 with little things on it that you kind of put in crops. It's kind of like those things. Yeah, so we have the Magic Kingdom Castle, Mickey and the Sorcerer's Hat, and Epcot Ball. Mm-hmm. And then today's Magic Band, the Magic Band that we got today,
2.0,
is the Magic Band 2.0, which is a great Magic Band. This one's the same, but it has a little circle instead of it just being thin. And inside the circle is, again, the Mickey head.
Yeah, let's see this one. All right, what's cool about the Magic Band 2.0, Emma did say the little circle in the middle. You look on the back, there's two screws that you can take out this little icon, and then you can put it in like a little keychain. You do have to buy it. You ain't gotta have the band, you just have a little keychain, you fill it up, same thing, Mickey to Mickey, and get you in the park.
And if you don't like wearing the wristband.
But notice, they are actually thinner than the 1.0s, just a little bit. not much.
And they're a little bit more circular.
But adding to the size of it, they are a little rounder on the edges. But wearing them, no different, same comfortable, unless you like bend your hand real hard. Other than that, they can't notice much of a difference on the Magic Bands. So yeah, that's our evolution of the Magic Bands.
Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to comment down below the last time you went to Disney World, or if you've ever been to Disney World. Also, make sure to press that like button and subscribe to my channel. Turn the button from red to gray. Click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Also, subscribe to his channel. Make sure to like his videos and comment down below on them. And click his bell to get notified when he posts a video. Again, he posts every Tuesday and Thursday. Also, I'm going to put his links down there, so if you cannot find his channel, it'll be down there, so you can just click that link. And yeah, so that's it for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Hey guys, it's Emily, and Merry Christmas! Today I'm going to be showing you my Christmas haul from things I received from family and friends. And before we get on the video, I just wanted to say that I'm very grateful for all the things I've gotten this year, and I hope every single one of you had a very Merry Christmas. And without further ado, let's get on to the video. First, I'm going to be showing you the things I've received from my family and Santa. So, every year I get a couple little things from Santa, and then I get one gift from my parents. So, in my stocking this year from Santa, I got this makeup bag, and it says a smile is the best makeup, and it's super, super cute, and I really loved it when I saw it. I was like, thank you, Santa, and it's really cute. It's very, I very much needed this for Disney World, so I can carry this around, that way I can hold my makeup. The next thing is a pack of gum, because if you know me, I love gum, especially at school. I always need gum at school. I don't know who doesn't need gum at school, but that was classic bubbles with bubble gum. I also got this chocolate Hershey bar. It's just regular milk chocolate, and it has a special design. So it's like, designed like a snowman or something, so that's cool. And the next thing I got from Santa is, there's a bunch of them in here. Okay, I got these little donut things, like they're donut lip balms, and here they are. There's six of them. There's a chocolate sprinkled donut, a pinwheel donut, I think that's what they're called, I don't know, a strawberry glazed donut, a regular glazed donut, just a regular donut with nothing on it, and a chocolate glazed donut, and they all smell really good. So yeah, those are lip balms, and so I'm so happy I got those from Santa, because I love lip balm and I love donuts, so it's perfect. The next thing I got are these little scrunchies, and they're like, I don't know, like not really velvet, but like, I don't really know what they're called, but yeah, they're scrunchies. I got a green, a beige, a navy blue, a pink blush color, and one that's like flowery. It's like red and flowery. But yeah, I really liked that, and it was super cute when I saw it in my stocking from Santa. And the last thing I got from Santa this year was a bunch of these hair ties, and that's what they look like. And I had one in this morning, but I took it out because I tried putting these on. So I have pink, purple, blue, yellow, and one that's like kind of like all different colors, like iridescent almost, but it didn't shine, so it's not iridescent, but it's like rainbow, so it's really pretty, and I really liked those. So thank you, Santa, for all my gifts this year. And every year I always get one big gift from my parents, and that's the one gift I get from my parents every year, and it was my backpack for Disney World and for traveling in. I promised y'all I'd make a video of what I would have in my backpack, so a backpack haul, and that will be coming very soon. I just got it today, so I'm going to be filming it as soon as possible, and I'm going to be getting it up as soon as possible. So yeah, this is what it looks like. It's a light blue, and it has one big zipper here and one little zipper inside, and it has one little zipper down here. And so I knew I was getting this gift for Christmas when I picked it out, but it's super cute and I really like it. And I found this bag at Claire's. Okay, now I'm going to be showing you a couple things that I received from my family that is not immediate family. So, from my cousins, I received a little gift certificate to a boutique in town so I can spend some money there. And then from my other cousins, I got a Francesca's gift card because I love Francesca's. And yeah, so I got a little gift card for that. And from my grandparents on my mom's side, I received these really cute, soft, fluffy shoes. They're so cute, and I've worn them not yet, but I will very soon because they're so soft and so comfortable. Like, I can't even, like, they're so, like, pretty and cute and comfy. Like, it's everything that, like, you need. Super soft, too, so, yeah. Now I'm going to be showing you a couple of things I received from my friends for Christmas. I'm not going to be showing them all because I've already eaten some things and used some things. So I'm just going to be showing you a couple of things that I have not yet to use yet. So the first thing is a couple of lotions and perfumes. I have a Snowy Morning body cream and a Sweet Escape Strawberry Picnic fragrance mist from two of my friends. And then also I received some candy, of course, from friends. Another thing I got was some accessories for like makeup and stuff. I have, this isn't really makeup, but it's a creamy shower gel. And then I also got some lip balms. This is a really cute lip balm, and it came from Sephora. I've already used it, but it smells really good. And then I got this really little bath. And then I got this really, really, really little blender. It's so little and so cute, and I really liked that when I saw it. And then one last thing that I got that I've not used yet is this from one of my friends. I have not tried it yet. It's hot chocolate with marshmallows in it. So there's like, I guess, little marshmallows. Ooh, I just don't want to open for them, but yeah, so I thought that was super cool, and I'm gonna try it because I love marshmallows in my hot chocolate. Also, one thing I got from my friends was I got these really cute mittens for when it's cold. It's already snowed here. I wish I had them, but I had some other mittens. But yeah, they're really super cute. Oh, you're not supposed to put them on this way, but there. It has my initial on it. It has an E for Emily. And then also for basketball, I'm number 3, so it fits good for that too. So it could be a 3 or an E, so yeah. Thank you to all my friends that have given me gifts. I'm sorry I cannot visit them all today, but thank you for all of those gifts. And thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video today. I hope you all had a very, very, very Merry Christmas, and I hope you have a very happy holiday. And yeah, so that's all for today. Please press that like button and comment down below what your favorite gift that you received this year was. And also subscribe to my channel and turn the bell for me. Also subscribe to my channel, turn that button from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. I will be posting a lot, very soon. All the way up into February, I'll be posting more than once a week. And so I'm very excited. I'm going to be telling you the next upcoming videos. There will be a bloopers and outtakes video soon. And there will be a backpack haul. And there will be Disney vlogs coming to you
at the end of December and the beginning of January. Also, stay tuned because in my upcoming videos, I'll also be telling you some more videos that'll be coming up soon. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please subscribe to my channel. That way you can watch more videos. And yeah, so thank you again for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. It's Emily and Happy New Year! This is my first video that is uploaded in 2018! And also, if you were watching this the day that it is uploaded, I am heading to Disney World right now. And so I thought, why not show you what's in my backpack for traveling, particularly for Disney World today. So I'm so excited. I'm going to Disney World right now if you're watching this the day that it's uploaded. And so, yeah, but before we get onto the video, make sure to press that like button and comment down below if you've ever been to Disney World. Now, let's see what's in my backpack. So, first thing is on my backpack, I did put my luggage tag on here because I wanted to. Because I don't have any, like, luggage, like, for a plane or anything. Like, we just have luggage that's going to be in our hotel room. So, I thought, why not just put it on my backpack and show my Disney spirit? That was really weird. On my littlest pocket, I have a lot of, like, little things in here. First thing I have is some gum, because after you eat the food, you're going to want some gum. So, got some gum. And then also, I'm going to be planning on wearing my hair down a lot, but I might want my hair up sometimes. So, I brought a bunch of different hair bands. I brought this that I got from Santa. If you have not seen my Christmas haul, make sure to go check that out. And then I also brought two regular ponytails. I'm so sorry, my dog is... Come over. He's sad. Thank you. And then the last hair tie that I have is like just a scrunchie, and it can be used as a bracelet or as a hair tie. So yeah, I got that. And then to put my hair up, I brought this little mini brush that I got from one of my friends. And it's really cute. It's rose gold, and I really like it. It's tiny, so it can fit in my backpack easily. So that's why I'm carrying this. Then I brought two types of lip balm. I brought one from Sephora that I showed in my Christmas haul also, and it can give your lips a little color. And then I brought this green EOS. So yeah. And then the last thing I have in my littlest pocket is Germex. It's warm vanilla sugar, and it smells so good. I love warm vanilla sugar. I also have something else warm vanilla sugar in the beads pocket, but let's wait to get to that. And actually, no, that's all in my littlest pocket, so let's go to the big pocket. Now let's go to my big pocket. So in my big pocket is a little pocket at the top up here, so I'm going to be showing what's in that first. So in here is where my other warm vanilla sugar is,
It's a lotion because my hands get like really like ugh and dry and all that. And it's not fun when you're trying to have fun when you have dry, gross hands. So I brought some lotion, and it is warm vanilla sugar, and it's from Bath & Body Works. So I love Bath & Body Works products. And then also in here, just to be careful, because sometimes I'll just look and like I have a cut on me that I didn't even know I had, and I don't have any Band-Aids, so I thought, let's bring some Band-Aids. So that way, also if I have a blister, I can just strap it on and give. So yeah, and then I have one more thing in here, and it is ibuprofen for headaches, because me and my mom get headaches a lot, and so when you're trying to have fun, headaches just get in the way, and it's horrible, and I hate it. So I brought ibuprofen, so that way we can just take this, and it'll go away, and we can have fun. Okay, so we're done with the little pocket, and now we're going to go to what's in the big pocket, actually. So two things that are not in here that will be in here when I go is my phone and my iPad, but those are not in here right now because I'm using them currently, but now, everything else that's in here is in here. Duh. Okay, so the first thing I have in here is some sunglasses because the sun is usually always out in Florida. So I got some sunglasses for when it's hot. But my dad said that we're gonna have to wear like sweatshirts all week. Like, all week. But anyway, so I brought sunglasses for when it's hot and I'm in line and maybe I might need them so I can just slip them on and be like, yeah, sun's not going to be in my eyes. Mm. Yeah. Cooper, stop messing with my light. Okay, the last thing that's in my bag is my GoPro and accessories. So this is the first accessory that I'm going to be using a lot. It's my GoPro stick. And I might show an unboxing of this. Maybe. I don't know. But I might. And so if you want to see that, comment down below. So this will probably be very helpful on rides that are fast, like Rock and Roller Coaster. I'll try to film on that. I'm probably just going to have to hold it like this and it'll probably like shake all around. But it's really great because if I accidentally drop it, it's strapped to my wrist, so it's not coming off. So hopefully that won't happen. Some other accessories I have in here is also another wrist one that I might not use as much. I might not take it, I don't know. But it's just another one that you put on your wrist, but you do not have to hold it. So it's just on your wrist and you could just go like this and be like, yeah. But I don't want to hold my arm up, so I might not take it, but who knows, I might. And then another one that I will also be using? And another one that I might also be using a lot will be this. It's a chest one, so it like goes on your chest so you don't have to hold anything and it just shows what's ever in front of you. I might also use this on Rock and Roller Coaster, I don't know, or on Tower of Terror. The last thing in my bag is the head one that I do not use a lot, and I might not use it a lot because I'm really scared that it's just gonna like slip off my head very slowly and then pop off and bye bye GoPro. It could happen, but yeah, I feel like I'm like a cave person when I have this on, but yeah, I might not use this as much either, like the little wrist one, but I don't know. I'm going to try to use as much as I can, but we'll see. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope that you're having a great start to the new year. I'm so excited. And also make sure to press that like button and comment down below if you've ever been to Disney World. And if you have, what's your favorite ride? Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of my videos and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. That way you can be the first view. And yeah, that's all for today. And I'll see you guys next time at Disney World. Bye. Hey guys, it's Emily and welcome back to the channel. Today's video is going to be my first Disney vlog, and so it's going to be the night of our first day, which is right now, and then tomorrow, which is our first day in the parks. So I hope you enjoy this video. If you do, make sure to press that like button and comment down below if you've ever been to Disney World. And now, let's go to Disney World! Hey guys, it's Emily, and so we're at the Magic Kingdom right now, and Christmas stuff is up and Christmas music is playing still, so I'm going to show you some things.
Here's the tree, it's still up, and they have a bunch of Christmas things up, and there's the castle! Yay! But they have a bunch of Christmas stuff up, and there's the castle. All good.
So the weather conditions aren't the best today. It's a little chilly outside.
Okay, I'm not in the bus.
And it's raining. It's at the bus station. So, but it's not horrible rain, so we're good.
Okay.
So for our first ride at Magic Kingdom and our first ride of our Disney trip, we're heading to Space Mountain right now because it's not crowded at all today. So Space Mountain is apparently 10 minutes or 15 minutes. So we're just gonna head there. All right, we're getting on Space Mountain right now, so I will film after.
What's the vibe like?
So we just got off of Space Mountain, and it was so fun. So I don't know where we're going next, but I'll update you. So we just got off of Buzz Lightyear, and it's raining outside. So we decided to try to find a ride that's inside. So now we're on Small World, so I'll try to film some on that. Thank you.
Yeah, I didn't bring those.
When hinges creak and doors change, and strange, frightening sounds echo through the hall, wherever candlelights break out with the air.
Hopefully the room will be ready by the time it stops.
We step away from all walls and into the dead center of the room.
Every time.
Your cadaverous pallor betrays an aura of foreboding, almost as though you sense a disquieting metamorphosis. Is this haunted room actually stretching, or is it your imagination? And consider this dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows and no doors. Which offers you this chilling challenge: to find a way out. Of course, there's always my way. Oh, I didn't mean to frighten you prematurely. The real chills come later. Now, as they say, look alive. And we'll continue our little
So we just rode Pirates of the Caribbean and the Jingle Cruise, and now we are eating at the Harbor House, I guess, in Liberty Square. So we got done eating, and then we rode Splash Mountain. We rode Splash Mountain in 40 degree weather while it's raining and cold, but the water was actually pretty warm, so it's okay. But now we're at Filler Magic.
Look at Ursula. Oh, she's so mean. I'll make you human if you give me your voice, she says. And Ariel gets all flustered and don't know what she's...
Thank you.
in sea. Now brings us glossitis, neck laryngitis, now go chain to me.
Hotel to go change because we're really wet from Splash Mountain in the rain. Yeah. So let's go to the hotel. Hey guys, so sorry I haven't vlogged in a while. As you can see, it's nighttime. It's what time?
Like,
Jeremy's over here.
It's, I don't know, 10 o'clock.
It's like almost 10 o'clock,
And we watched Happily Ever After. I put some clips in there, as you could see. And we rode a couple rides. But my parents left after the fireworks. And so me and my brother are here by ourselves right now. And we're going to go back around 11. And the park's open until 2, so, but we're not staying that long. We just got off of Pirates of the Caribbean, and we're heading over to Tomorrowland to ride Astro Orbiter. So let's go. Okay, guys, so I know you can't see me, but I'm here. So change of plans. We're going to go to Barnstormer, maybe Dumbo, and then we're going to go head over to Astro Orbiter if it still has a pretty short time wait. I'm sure it probably will overnight. So, yeah, we're about to go get on Barnstormer because it's a pretty short wait. And Dumbo, maybe, because nobody's on it. Okay, guys, so we just got off of Barnstormer, and now we are heading to Dumbo. So, yeah. Thank you. So, right now we're on Dumbo. We're about to take flight. So, I'm going to try to film some. Okay, guys, so my phone unexpectedly died on me while I was in line for Dumbo. So, we rode Dumbo, we rode the Tomorrowland Speedway, we rode Astro Orbiters, we rode People Mover, we rode Splash Mountain because we got Fast Pass for it, and now we're on Thunder Mountain, or we're in line for it. So, I'll try to film some more after we get off. So, again, you cannot see me, but we just got off of Thunder Mountain, and that was the last ride of the night, day. It's midnight. I don't know what day it is.
Fourth.
Okay. Wait, it's midnight?
Pretty close.
It's midnight, basically. We're going back to the hotel because we're cold, and really, we were supposed to be back at the hotel by 11. That's what our parents said. But we kept riding so many rides that were walk-ons. Like, it was actually a pretty good day for, like, riding. Like, you didn't have to wait in line for really anything except for, like, Mine Train and Space Mountain. So, overall, this is actually a really pretty good day. Sorry I couldn't vlog a lot today, but I'll try to vlog as much as I could. I'll try to vlog as much as I can the next days. We'll come back to Magic Kingdom a lot, so that's gonna do it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button and comment down below how many times you've been to Disney World or if you've ever been to Disney World. And subscribe to my channel, turn the button from red to gray, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today is Disney Vlogs day number 2. Today we are at Epcot and we are in line for Soarin' right now, moving pretty quickly right now, but it was a 35 minute wait, but we haven't caught up with the line yet. So, oh, we found it. So you can't really see me, but I'm here. So we're going to be at Epcot today. We might go to Hollywood Studios after, but I'll update you after the ride. So we just got off the Soarin', and I think we're about to go head over to Test Track because we have fast passes for it. But it said it was temporarily closed on the My Disney Experience app, but we're going to go over there and check and see if it's still closed. So we looked at our My Disney Experience and our Test Track fast passes were changed, which means it's probably not going to open for a little bit. So we're going to go see if we can get fast passes for the Frozen ride. So apparently we could use the extra fast pass for any ride except for Frozen. So I guess we're I don't know if we're going to use it or not. We're heading to Spaceship Earth right now, the golf ball, basically. And, yeah. So, we're going to go in there, and then we're going to go to the land. And then maybe it'll be time for our Nemo and friends fast pass. So, let's go ride Spaceship Earth. So, we decided to use our fast pass on Spaceship Earth, so we're about to get on it right now. We're probably not going to film on this, so I'll update you after.
Hey guys, we're stuck on Spaceship Earth and they finally turned the lights on. We've been up here for about 10 minutes, so finally they turned the lights on.
How did
we
get out?
Oh goodness. This is definitely one of my favorite rides.
Hey, I'm filming too.
So much fun.
So, yeah. There's some dude coming to unlock all the doors. We just had a lot of fun. I didn't get to see my future I created, but I think now we're going to Living with the Seas or something.
Ladies and gentlemen, our time travels have been momentarily delayed. Please remain seated. Your time machine vehicle will begin moving again at any moment. Please remain seated. We'll resume our journey shortly. Thank you.
So we're just waiting to get our door unlocked so we can walk down the stairs and leave. We've stopped.
They need to dash, Richard. Look at the thing in front of us.
Look at
the thing in front of us.
Look over here. All
right.
Evacuate.
EVAC.
So.
Where's the EVAC?
Yeah. We're pretty sure. Yeah, there's my mom and there's my dad and my brother back there. They're not looking.
That's hoodie on.
Yeah. So, we're just gonna wait for our door to get unlocked and then we're gonna leave and go to the Nemo thing, I think, because we have fast passes for it. Yeah, I'll give y'all a video of that, but until...
Ladies and gentlemen, our time travels have been momentarily delayed. Please remain seated. Your time machine vehicle will begin moving again at any moment. Please remain seated. We'll resume our journey shortly. Thank you.
Why don't you not play him?
The time travel expert will be with you shortly. Please remain seated.
These people aren't experts if they can get this thing to start.
We gotta start at the top.
We gotta start at the top.
But I'll show you us walking through whenever they unlock our door, which could be a while. So, we just got out of our time machine, I guess, and we're heading down, but we have to wait because the lady in front of us has gotta open all the doors in front of us, so. I'll try to show you some things. We finally got off of Spaceship Earth and now we have a fast pass for the seas with Nemo and friends. So we're gonna go do that and then I think we're gonna eat after.
We just keep your eyes open for on the way.
Nemo,
oh, let's go explore, explore. Let's go explore the big blue world.
Why are you trying to find him?
Find who?
Oh, Nemo! Where are you, Nemo?
Who's Nemo?
He's my son. You know that.
I do.
We went on a huge adventure together.
Games. I love games.
What's your name?
Yes.
Jellyfish.
Right.
Oh,
now. I'm
going to say
incredible.
That's jellyfish.
They're good.
Okay,
and I'm thinking.
Jellyfish! And the next one, jellyfish.
All right, Mr. Smarty Pants.
Don't stop playing games.
We got off of the seas and then we realized we had fast passes for Mission Space, so we got on that. We just got off the orange Mission Space and now we're eating at Electric Umbrella. I'm pretty sure after this we're going to Hollywood Studios. I'll
probably video when we get to Hollywood Studios, so.
Okay, guys, so we had a little change of plans. We got done eating at Electric Umbrella, and my parents went back to the hotel, and me and my brother are in line for Test Track right now. We're in the single rider's line because it's much faster, and you can get in on the ride faster. So we just got in on that, and now I will video on my GoPro on Test Track, and then I'll video on my phone when we go to Hollywood Studios. Hey guys, we're at Hollywood Studios now, and I know we're doing Fantasmic. I don't know what we're gonna do before, but so yeah, I don't know what we're gonna do before then, but I'll let you know when I find out.
Thank you. invade this land in the name of His Majesty, King James the First.
Last night, we went to Magic Kingdom and we went to Laugh Floor, rode Thunder Mountain, rode Pirates of the Caribbean, and then we stayed in Life or Mine Train and went back to the hotel. So that was all we did yesterday, and I hope you enjoy the video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Hello guys, we are at Hollywood Studios. It's day three and right now we're in line for Rock and Roller Coaster because our fast passes have not started yet for our first ride. But right now we're waiting in line for Rock and Roller Coaster, so I'll film some more when we get a little bit more ahead in line. Alright guys, so we just got off of Rock and Roller Coaster and I'll insert a picture right now. So we're on our way to our first fast pass. It's Toy Story Mania. I'll video when we get over there. Okay guys, so we're on in line for Toy Story now, and I probably won't film on this ride, so I'll see you after. Okay guys, so we just got done eating and now we're doing our fast pass for Star Tours, and then we're gonna go back to the hotel and rest a minute, and then I think me and my mom are gonna go to Disney Springs. So I'm gonna film after Star Tours, so see you then.
Stand by for systems check. Forward lights. Check.
Come on.
Check. Check. Emergency fuel vent. Check. I said check on. Shut up now before you blow up the whole place. Sometimes after I can't understand your logic.
Proof of ownership is required for all droid passengers.
He's a mouse droid.
Clanky, talking, laughing.
Okay guys, so we are leaving Hollywood Studios right now and we're going to the hotel and we're going to rest a little bit and then maybe we'll go to Disney Springs. Okay guys, so me and my mom are at Disney Springs, or I think we're here. So we're basically just going to go shopping a little bit until around 5 o'clock. That's when we're gonna leave to go to Magic Kingdom, so we're probably gonna leave here around 4 or something like that. So it's 2:10 right now, so we're gonna be shopping here for maybe a little over an hour. Yeah, I'll see you inside. Okay guys, so we are at Disney Springs now, and so we're gonna go to the Disney store and see if we can find some things in there. Okay guys, we got back from Disney Springs. We got a couple of things there. And we're gonna head to the Magic Kingdom, but I'm not gonna video that. So that's all for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today is day 4, and we're at Animal Kingdom, and right now we're heading to Pandora. None of us have seen Pandora yet, so we're excited.
I take big steps.
Okay guys, so we're gonna ride Navi River Journey because it's only a 15 minute wait, that's what it says. So I'll try to film some on the ride. We just got off of Navi River Journey, and we're heading to Mount Everest, I'm pretty sure, so yeah, I'll film some when we get there. Okay guys, so we rode Mount Everest twice, and now we're in line for Kilimanjaro Safari. We got fast passes for it, so we're almost on.
Right to feet and quiet backwaters, like you see here in the Safi River. Something like zebra in the wilderness. Can I have a sit down, please? Now those horns curve backwards, which discourages predators like the lion. They can get 18 to 20 feet tall. A group of giraffes is known as a tower. Now the giraffe we have here in Harambe is known as a Maasai. Now a springbok gets his name because it leaps up and down repeatedly. They lose those gray feathers and they get replaced with white ones. Then the beta carotene and the brine shrimp and other aquatic animals that eats turn those feathers pink over time. It's the lightest pink color of the flamingos.
Okay guys, so we're in Hollywood Studios. And right now we're in line for Star Tours because Rock and Roller Coaster was a little long, about 125 minutes, and the single rider was not open, so we came over here, so we're gonna ride it in like an hour or so. Okay, so we got off of Star Tours, and now we are in line for Rock and Roller Coaster. It's less than a 2 hour wait, so maybe we might get on before 6, so I'll try to film some when we get inside the building. Okay guys, so we finally got on Rock and Roller Coaster, and then we left and went to Animal Kingdom, and we're about to get on Flight of Passage because we have fast passes for it. So I'm not gonna film on this, so I'll try to film after when we go to Rivers of Light. Okay guys, we're at Rivers of Light and the show's starting, so I'm gonna show you some highlights of that.
Celebrate the magnificence and wonder of all living creatures.
Thank you. It's our last day at Disney World.
Okay, guys, so today is our last day at Disney World, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to film a lot today, but I'll try. So, we're at the Magic Kingdom, and we're going to be here the whole day until, like, around 4, because our fast passes end around 4 sometime, I think. So, we're going to try to make the best of it today, and then maybe we'll come back next year. Okay, guys, so right now we're in line for Peter Pan, and I have not been through the new line yet, so I'll try to show you some.
Look at this beautiful view out of our window.
Okay, guys, so we got off of Peter Pan, then we rode Small World, and now we are in line for Haunted Mansion with a 13-minute wait. So, also, we were in Small World, and if you know, there's Jeremy, if you know, there's, like, at the end, the scene is where it says, like, bye in a bunch of different languages, and on the signs, it has names on it, and our family got our names on there, so it was cool. So now we're in line for Haunted Mansion, so yeah. Okay, guys, now we're on Splash Mountain. Yay. Okay, so we just got off of Splash Mountain, and now we're riding the train over to the Mine Train because we have fast passes for it. So we just got off of Mine Train, and now we are in line for the teacup. I couldn't film on the bus because I was standing up and trying to not fall, but we're here at Hollywood Studios,
and we're only gonna ride Rock and Roller Coaster. That's our last ride of Disney, our Disney trip. And I'm really sad. I might film with my GoPro on it, I don't know, but. So yeah, we're walking into Hollywood Studios. This is the last park, last ride that we're ever gonna do. This is our actual last Fast Pass. But that was the last Fast Pass that we planned on doing. So I'm really excited. We're ending off with my favorite ride, Rock and Roller Coaster. And yeah, so it's sad, but I'm really excited that we're ending with my favorite ride. Alright guys, that was the last ride at Disney World. Super sad. I wanted to ride it again, but we gotta leave tonight and then we'll get home tomorrow. So that's gonna be all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed all my Disney vlogs. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!